Well, thank you for the time to be on Nicole's views.
I've been so dedicated to actually building my brand.
I think you're brilliant in a lot of different areas too. I mean, you have a lot of different genres you're bringing to the set, and just amazing. I hope I get to work with you someday.
Actually, produce different certain projects that the audience can appreciate. Like in my case, I'm a martial artist, but I'm a comedian as well. And I also love to do drama scenes or passion scenes. So I want to share with you guys, and this is my magic box, you know?
What?
It's my magic
box. You have a magic box? A magic box. Okay, what's in there? Let me see.
I got a gun, you know?
Yeah.
With metal on top. So this one, I'm going to use it on a upcoming film of action.
What is that?
What do these look like?
Potato? Rocks? I don't know. Rocks?
So, you know, these are makeup props for wounds. You know, this is fake flesh.
Oh, it is? Like really rubbery? Can you squeeze it? Like squeeze
yeah, look.
It? Oh, yeah, yeah. I like that. Okay. Yeah. I like how a scene gets put together. I like prop sets. I like setting up the scene. And I like the special effects, too. I'm
right.
That. Yeah.
Like these are two types of blood colors. So this is the darker one and this is the brighter one. So the perfect blend for you to have a perfect wound, it's actually make a darker tone of blood so that the wound mixes with the fake flesh and it looks absolutely real, you know?
Oh, love it. Yeah. Antonio Sabalos on IMBD.
Right. Please, you guys just click on my IMDb. There's one of my latest credits. It's called Fortune Wheel. So I'm so excited. You know, it's a film that actually talks about the tarot cards. It talks about superstition, magic. Gosh, it has almost every single ingredient for a great short film. I'm so, so excited about it. I once posted on Instagram a tribute picture of me being about, let's say, 9 years old when I started. And next to me is Jean-Claude Van Damme's Street Fighter movie picture. You have no idea. I tagged Jean-Claude Van Damme, and the dude and the legend actually commented my post. You know, that was crazy.
It is amazing when you see people that have been in the showbiz for so long, and they do acknowledge your hard work and effort because they've been there at one time where they first started off, and they're building, and they're doing, and they're collaborating.
I started doing some wrestling promos, like something like this, right? Hey, listen, Nicole Vegas, if you're ready to take on Big Daddy Cool, that's right, Antonio Superstar, get ready for the wildest ride of your whole wide entire life, baby. You know?
Yeah. I have to say, who did you practice on? I'm just throwing it out there. Who did you practice on? Because my brother used to practice on me, camel clutch and figure fours, and I'm like tapping out. Yeah. Who did you practice on?
I actually started doing YouTube videos with wrestling YouTube videos, cutting promos and wrestling. And, you know, I just emulated Ric Flair's Nature Boy. And that really, you know, built the momentum for my decision to say, you know, if I can do this for YouTube videos, I got to get started in acting because acting is a very, very important part of pro wrestling.
But I was reading a Host Media Corporation TV show. So you do have that experience to really captivate and put people out there and really heighten that charisma and that attention that people seek out. You know, they like to be entertained and you are very entertaining.
When you're filming, you got to choose the locations right. You got to prepare your actors. You got to instruct your actors. You got to find the perfect angles. You know, shooting a film is very, very rigorous. And, you know, the hardest thing of this film was, as I was telling you, the visual effects, artificial intelligence. You know, the beach, shooting on the beach was like 6 hours away from home. So, you know, budget here and there. You know, I always take pride on treating my actors as kings and queens, you know, because they are the ones that actually help build my brand. So they're royalty for me. So, you know, and you know, now I know that there's people watching this show. If there are producers and directors, you know, please, you know, treat your talents as royalty because they built your name, your brand, and all the projects that are in your head into reality, ladies and gentlemen. The most interesting about this film is that I didn't actually have a complete script for the film. So believe it or not, Nicole, no. Believe it or not, things went happening by along the months. Like, one of the things that happened is my in real life, my grandmother passed away. And one of the things I decided at the funeral was that, hey, of course, I want to make a homage. I want to pay some tribute to my late grandmother. I took the cameras with me. I recorded it. And I actually put those scenes on the film.
Tarot card reading and mediums and all that stuff. It looked like you had a romantic scene. You have a romantic scene in there? It's a little bit of, what's it like? Because I'm kind of curious, what's it like to film a romantic scene? And is that your first one?
No. It's actually not my first. It's pretty cool. And not just in acting, but in modeling. So I'm a model as well. And actually, I've posed naked with female models for catalogs.
I will share those pictures too. I'll make a reel or anything. But what can you share a little bit of what that's like? What goes through your mind when you're going through that?
That's pretty interesting. So, you know, a lot of people, when they've seen me, my pictures with these beautiful ladies naked, they all tell me, gosh, dude, you're so lucky, you know, you're so lucky. But you know, one of the aspects of making a great picture is that when you're on set naked with your female model partner, gosh, believe me, Nicole, the last thing you're actually looking is her body. And here's the reason why. Because the photographer actually wants you to just make this, you know, this gesture, this posture that requires your total focus in the outcome of the picture. So there's like some pictures in which I hold the models, you know, let's say by their waist and pick them up. So I gotta be so concentrated on my gestures, on my posture, so that the final product of the picture becomes successful. On Devil's Playground, there's this international model, runway model. Her name is Angela Renee. She lives on Iowa. So I talked to her and I proposed her to be part of my film. So how did this work? She actually allowed me to use some of her footage and pictures on my movie. And I actually portrayed her as 1962's United States pageant contestant model. So that's her, you know.
Oh, beautiful. That's hot.
Yeah.
It's very gorgeous.
She's beautiful, and she actually went to Paris. So I've been building these connections to make my films internationally as far as talent. You know, on the Fortune Wheel film, there's this actress. Her name is Lee Sanchez. She's from Spain. So she did a wonderful scene where she cries and she's so sad about one of the cars. What is the daggers card? They show a lot of sadness. So she portrayed a beautiful, beautiful crying scene, kind of like representing Virgin Mary. And you know, she sent me her clip, her scene through WeTransfer. I edited that video and I put it right into my film. And that's one of the things I want to do with you, Nicole. I'd love to have one of my films. Let's make this official. You know, I brought my clapper with me today. Can you read what it says?
What's it say? Oh, Nicole Vegas Views. Yes.
Yeah, there we go.
Lynn, ready, action.
And action. There we go. It's official wrap up.